students, in this session we will discuss about state space representation using phase variables method. See, in the previous video we have discussed about method 1 of the state space representation using the phase variables. Here we will discuss about the method 2. See, here we will be given a differential equation. Sometimes we may be given a Laplace transform equation, okay? So first method, in the case of method 2, let us start with the discussion using the differential equation representing the systems. So we will be given a differential equation governing a system, and that differential equation is in terms of the output, that is y of t. So we will get the differential equation as yn dot plus a1 yn minus 1 dot plus etc. up to an minus 1 y dot plus ANY equal to B0 UM dot plus B1 UM minus 1 dot plus etc. So we have to start here. In order to reduce the complication, we are taking N equal to M equal to 3. So we can write this equation as whenever N equal to M equal to 3, you will get this is Y 3 dot, okay, plus A1 into Y 2 dot plus A2 into Y dot plus A3 into Y equal to. Similarly, here also we will get B0 U triple dot plus B1 U double dot plus B2 U dot plus B3 U. Okay, that is for the simplicity of analysis. So now we have this equation. So we can then assign the state variables such as X1, X2, X3 instead of Y. Okay, that was the thing that we have done in the method 1, okay? So in the method 1, we have substituted instead of y1 equal to x1 and y dot equal to x2 and y double dot equal to x3. That was the substitution that we have done in the previous method. So here we are going for taking the Laplace transform. See, whenever we are taking the Laplace transform of this equation, see, this is a third differential term, so its Laplace transform will give you s cube into y of s. Here we are not taking the initial condition, so other terms corresponding to this third differential will be cancelled out. So next term is a1 into y double dot. What is its Laplace transform? A1 into s square into y, right? Similarly, we will get a2 into s into y of s plus a3 into y of s. That will be equal to b0 into s cube into u of s plus etc. So this is obtained by taking the Laplace transform, okay? So here we can take y of s outside and here we can take u of s outside. So we will get the terms like this. So whenever we are writing y of s by u of s, we can take this to right side. So you will get this form. And here we are taking s cube, that is highest power here. Okay, s cube outside from both numerator and from denominator. So you will get s cube and s cube cancelled. So you will get this form. See, here we are getting the y of s by u of s. That is output by input will be equal to this form. So you have remember the Mason's gain formula, right? Which is equal to transfer function equal to 1 by delta into sigma k pk del k. Here pk is the path gain of kth forward path, del k is the 1 minus sum of loop gains of all individual loops plus sum of gain products of all possible combinations of two non-touching loop minus etc. Del k is the delta for that part of the graph which is not touching the kth forward path. That is, we have studied in the first module of the control system, okay? So here we can write when we are substituting, see here we have t of s is equal to 1 by delta into this equation, and when we are substituting k value, suppose k equal to 4, then we will be getting, that means k equal to 4 means there will be 4 forward path, right? So we will be getting this equal to P1 delta 1, P2 delta 2, etc. divided by 1 minus P11 plus P12 plus P13. Here we are getting this by taking an assumption that the transform function of the system have 4 forward path with 3 feedback loop which is touching each other. So we are getting the equation P1 plus P2 plus P3 plus P4. That means here there will be 4 forward path and delta 1 and delta 2 and delta 3 and delta 4 equal to 1. That is our assumption. So when we are having 3 feedback loop which is touching each other, then we will get the denominator side as 1 minus P11 plus P12 plus P13. So this is the transfer function equation by using the Mason's gain formula. So what we are going to do is we are comparing this equation with the previous equation. Previously we have get the transfer function, that is output by input will be equal to B0 plus B1 by S plus B2 by S square plus B3 by S cube divided by this term. So we are comparing all these quantities. So at the numerator side, here it is P1, P2, P3, P4. You can equate this numerator. So you will get P1 equal to B0, P2 equal to B1 by S, P3 equal to B2 by S square, P4 equal to B3 by S cube. What is its meaning? These all are forward path. So in this case, in the forward path, there is no integrator. Here its meaning is B1 by S means there will be one integrator. P3 equal to B2 by S square means there will be two integrators. In P4 equal to B3 by S cube, that means there will be three integrators, right? So that is its meaning, okay? So when P11 here, we can also compare the denominator terms. So here the denominator is 1 minus. So P11 is minus A1 by S, right? Similarly, P12 is equal to minus A2 by S square, and P13 equal to minus A3 by S cube. So you can make that substitution, okay? So P11 equal to minus A1 by S, P12 equal to minus A2 by S square, P13 is equal to minus A3 by S cube. That is your substitution. And what is its meaning? These all are loop gains, right? So there will be a scalar A1, here there will be a scalar A2, there will be a scalar A3. These all are minus A1, minus A2, minus A3, and this is integrator, okay? So that is its meaning. So we have to construct a signal flow graph by using these parameters, okay? By using these equations. So let us see how can we draw this signal flow graph here. You know that input is U of S and output is Y of S. That is from the discussion. The input can be represented by a node, which is given here, and output is represent another node Y of S. And we don't know what are the other nodes and all. First of all, let us start. U of S is going to directly a node. So its gain will be 1 or scalar will be 1. And we know that here first forward path, there will be 4 forward path, P1, P2, P3 and P4. And P1 has no integrators. Okay. So here how many integrators will be there? There will be 3 integrators, right? So that will be represented by state variables x1 dot x1 double dot or x1 dot x1 double x1 dot x2 dot and x3 dot, right? All integrators are represented by like this. So that is the input to the integrator is x1 dot x2 dot and x3 dot. So here when considering P1, it is directly a forward path which is having a scalar B0. So we can, it does not contain any integrator. So we can draw a straight line from input to output. So P1 will be equal to here this B0. So we don't know how many nodes will be in between these two. Okay. So P1 directly goes to B0 and there will, we can draw a node here. Okay. We doesn't notate anything or any name for that node, for this input node or for this output node. Next, what is the next term? Next is P2. P2 is equal to B1 by S. That means there will be one integrator from input to output in that case. And in the case of P3, there will be two integrators. And in the case of P4, there will be three integrators. So, let us see. We are first not using integrators. So, we can represent each node, three nodes in between this input and output. Up to this, we have U of S and Y of S node here. And also, we have drawn this B0 node here. And all other nodes we just marked. So, we are marking three nodes, that is 1, 2 and 3. And we don't know what are the values for that node or what is the name of that node. So, we can simply represent 1 by S before that node, right? Since in the case of an integrator, the input to that integrator will be input to that integrator will be a derivative term, right? So here you can see that here this one is equal to p4 will go for, in the case of p4 there will be three integrators, so b3 will be, see here it will go to four integrators, so first integrator is here and second integrator is here having 1 by s term, third integrator is here 1 by s, so p3, that means p3 has to go through three integrators, so b3 will be before these three integrators, that means we have to draw from this node to this node as b3, so b3 will go through this integrator, this one and this one, so it will be b3 by s cube. Okay, so b3 will go to this integrator, so there is a node, so at this point what will we name that node? See, in the case of b3, that is p4, b3, we know that there will be an input which is the derivative, of the state variable, so we are notating that state variable as x3 dot, that is simply our notation, so x3 dash x3 dot comes here, so at the output it will become x3. Okay, so next from x3, after that there will be another integrator, so at the input there will be another node which is having a value derivative value, so that will be, we are notating it as x2 dot, so it output it will be x2. Next we have another integrator and its input will be another differentiative term, that is equal to x1 dot, so we will get x1 here. Now we have marked b3 and x3 dot, x3, x2 dot, x1, x1 dot, x2 dot, x2, x1 dot and x1 here, so we doesn't mark any other quantities, we have marked 1 by s, 1 by s, 1 by s and we doesn't marked this quantity. See here we have also know that p3 will be equal to b2 by s square, what is its meaning? P3 in the forward path there will be two integrators and there will be a scalar b2, so that is also a forward path, so here one integrator comes here, other will be coming here, and so b2 should go to this integrator, so b2 will go to this integrator first then second integrator, so it will become b2 by s square. Similarly in the case of p4 it is b3 by s cube, so we can draw p3 is equal to b3 goes here and then it will go to three integrators. Similarly b0 it doesn't go through any integrator, so we doesn't mark that, we mark it at the output of this integrator. Okay, next is p2, in that case it will go to only one integrator, so we can draw that forward path as b1 into it will go to only through this integrator, so we can end that b1 at this point. Okay, so all other points we have marked the gain as 1 1 1. Okay, like this is the way we are marking the forward paths. And similarly there is another term, that is loop, this is minus a1 by s, what is its meaning? This is an individual loop and it is, since its value is negative, that means it goes backward, and see here this scalar will go through one integrator, what is its meaning? So from the output it will go through one integrator alone, so we can see at the output here it will go to only one integrator, so it will go to from x1 it will go to this point. Okay, so this is minus 1, after that it will go to one integrator alone, and next term is p12, that means it will go it has a scalar minus a2 and it will go to two integrators, so what is the second integrator? This is one integrator and this is other integrator, so at this point it will go, so from output a2 will goes here. Similarly in the case of a3, it is negative, that means it is a feedback, negative feedback, and its scalar value is minus a3, it will go through three integrators, so from the output it will go to this point, because first integrator is here, second is here, third is here, so it will go to here, minus a3 go to here, then it will go to first integrator, second integrator and third integrator. This is the way we are drawing this. So we have to know how can we draw a signal flow graph when we are getting the equation in this form. See, when we are getting the equation in the form like this, okay? So we have to, next what we have to do is we have to construct or we have to find the state equations corresponding to x3 dot, x2 dot, x1 dot, like that. So we have to consider each of these node. See, first we are considering s1 dot node. So whatever are the inputs and outputs from this x1 dash. So at the x1 dash point, b1 comes here, from the x2 it comes here. Also from minus a1 it comes here. But minus a1 coming from this node, that is coming from b0. So when we are writing the equation for x1 dot, we can write x1 dot will be equal to minus a1 into b0 into u plus x1, because minus a1 is multiplied by these two quantities and that will go to x1 dot, and then also x2 will be added to it. So plus it will be equal to b1 into u. Okay, so this is the case of x1, x1 dot. Okay, you can simply write that x1 dot. So here this will be multiplied by other quantities in the bracket, so you will get this. Similarly, you can write the equations of x2 dot and x3 dot. See, x2 dot is here. What all are the inputs coming here? This is coming here, this one is coming here, and next a2 is coming here. At the a2, what all are the quantities coming from here? And b0. So you can write x2 dot will be equal to minus a2 into x1 plus b0 into u plus x3 into, there is another term, that is equal to b2 into u. Okay, so that is the thing. And next, in the case of x3 dot, you can similarly write the equations. So you, now you have three equations, x1 dot, x2 dot, and x3 dot. So you can write it in the matrix form. So you will get the matrix form will be equal to x1 dot, x2 dot, x3 dot is equal to minus a1, minus a2, minus a3. See, this is obtained from this equation. In the x1 dot, x1 corresponding to x1, that is, there is a term minus a1, that is a quotient, and x2 quotient is 1, and x3 quotient is not there. Okay, so it is putting as a 0. And in the x2 dot equation, x1 quotient is minus a2, x2 quotient is 0, x3 quotient is 1. That is why we are writing this. Okay, similarly, you can write x3 dot also. And the form is x dot, x equal to a into x plus b into u. That is your form. A and x is obtained. Next, b term is obtained from, in the case of x1 dot, b, what is the b term? That is equal to b1 minus a1 b0. So you can write it there. And in the case of next term, b2 minus a2 minus b0, and next term b3 minus a3 minus b0. So you can write that term, and you can write u. So when we are considering the output, what is output? Output is y. How will you get obtain y? Y will be equal to, what is the y term? X1 into 1. What is x1? What all our quantities will be there in the x1 term? You can write it as a x1 plus b0 into u. See, y will be equal to x1 plus b0 into u. Where is b0 coming from? U. Okay, b0 into u, that is y. So you can write the output equation as a, instead of, output equation will be in the form of, you know that it is in the form of c into x plus d into u. So c will be here, instead of here x1 term, what will be the x1? X1 term is only 1, and x2 and x3 will be 0. Other terms, in that case, there is no x2 and x3, so you can write 0, 0. And instead of b0, you can write b0 and u. This is the form by obtained state model, obtained by using the method 2. Okay, so this is a little more complex comparing to the method 1. Sometimes you may be asked for solving the equation, for solving the problem by using method 1 or method 2. That is why I am explaining all this. And let us see how can we draw a how can we do a problem by using this. See, this is the same representation for the nth order differential equation. Next, we can do a problem. This is a university question. See, y of s by u of s, that is equal to 10 by s cube plus 4s square plus 2s plus 1. So first of all, what we have to do is we have to represent it in the form of Mason's gain formula. So it will be equal to 10 divided by s cube into 1 plus, here we are taking s cube outside. We have to express the denominator in the form of 1 plus or 1 minus term. That is why we are taking s cube outside. So s cube into 1 plus, other terms will be this. So s cube can be taken upper side, that is equal to 10 by s cube 1 minus. So this is in the form of mass and skein formula. Next we have to draw this signal flow graph. That is a little complex one. Here we know that there will be three integrators. So first of all we can draw that three integrators. That is 1 by s, 1 by s and 1 by s. Its input will be derivative. First derivative is x3 dot, next is x3. And in this case x2 dot x2. In this case x1 dot and x1. Okay, so input will be u and output is y, that is we marked here. And from the input, what is the gain of the input path? 10. So 10 will be the input path. Here there is no other forward path, there is only one forward path which is having path gain 10. So this is the only forward path. Okay, so how many loops will be there? Loops is minus 4 by s, minus 2 by s square, minus 1 by s cube. There will be three loops, and the first minus 4 goes to only one integrator, so minus 4 from x1 will go to x1 dot, so it will go to this integrator alone. Next minus 2 by s square, so it will go to two integrators since s square term here. So minus 2 into two integrators are, first integrator is second integrator, so from the x1 it will be fed back as minus 2 and it will go to x2 dot, then it will go to first integrator, then go to the second integrator. Okay, next is minus 1 by s cube, so feedback path having a scalar value minus 1 and it will go to first integrator, so that it will be go through three integrators. So this is a signal flow graph representation. In this signal flow graph you have to write the equations of x3 dot, x2 dot and x1 dot. So you should mark what all quantities coming to x3 dot, u is coming and also minus 1 into x1, x1 signal, 1 by s into x1 signal is also coming there, and output is output, we doesn't require output in order to write the x3 dot equation. Okay, so you can write x3 dot will be is equal to minus, in the it is marked here in the case of x3, x3 dot what all quantities are coming is 10u and minus x1 is coming, x3 dot minus minus x1 into plus 10u is coming here, and in the case of x2 dot what all our quantities coming here is, in the case of x2, x3 is coming here and also minus 2 x1 is coming here, x3 is coming here and minus 2 x1 is coming here, so that will be x2 dot is equal to minus 2 x1 plus x3, and x3 dot what all quantities are coming here, in the case of x3 dot 10 into u is coming here and minus 1 into x1 coming here, so in the case of x3 dot minus 1 into x1 coming here and 10 into u coming here. Okay, so this is the state equations. We can represent it in the case in the form of matrix, that is x1 dot x2 dot x3 dot, here minus 4 1 0 coming, that is from minus 4 is the quotient of x1, 1 is the quotient of x2, since there is no x3 term so the quotients will be 0. And in the case of x2 dot, first quotient is minus 2, second quotient is 0, third quotient is x3 quotient, that is 1. So here the first quotient is minus 1, second quotient is 0, third quotient is also 0. And similarly we can write the output equation. What is the output? Output is y, y is x1 alone. Okay, there is no part of u, so y is equal to x1 alone. So we can write the x1 y equation as, in that case instead of x1, x1 quotient is 1, x2 and x3 quotients are 0. Similarly column matrix is x1, x2, x3. Okay, so this is the output equation and this is the state equations. So these two equations, these two presents the state model in the case of phase variable method 2. Okay, so this is all about this topic. Thank you.